Here we have another extremely unloved Seiko automatic, and as you can see, it's in quite a state. It looks as if it's suffered quite a trauma. There are parts floating around inside the perspex crystal. Looks like the 12 o'clock chapter has become detached, and also the calendar window. The second hand has also dropped off, and the crystal has a missing piece, so somebody's covered up the whole thing with a little bit of tape so that the bits and pieces don't get lost. And my main concern here is the dial. This may have been scratched up by those floating parts, but we'll find out soon enough. Now this has the Seiko 7625 movement fitted, which is an automatic movement. It's made by Seiko in the 1960s, and it features the so-called magic lever style of winding mechanism, which, as it turns out, is very robust and reliable. As far as I'm aware, aside from the cosmetic issues, the movement is still intact. It's only been serviced or worked on once or twice in its lifetime. The strap is not original. The owner actually prefers the Fixoflex style bracelet instead, and the case has a thick plating of gold. However, this is wearing off a little bit. I may clean it up later, but first I need to strip the watch down, clean it, and see what performance I can get out of it. I'm going to start by removing that nasty tape. I'm interested to see if the dial is scratched up or not. And the second's hand looks quite bent, but it should be okay. I'm pretty sure I have a spare used original, and I've got a glass that I can replace this one with as well. So looking at the dial, it doesn't look that bad at all. A few fine scratches, but really nothing serious. Okay, I shall continue and remove the watch from the case. I can see a nasty scratch on the rotor. One thing I have noticed is that the rubber back seal has hardened, and this makes it difficult to remove the movement ring, therefore the movement from the case. So to be safe, I'm going to remove the weight and unscrew the movement from its ring, and the whole module should just drop out from the dial side as the glass and bezel are already removed. And now it's safer to really get in there and dig out the hardened gasket. And now I can remove the dial and hands. And just before I go any further, I've wound up the watch and it does run, so let's just take a quick look at its performance. And as we can see, it's gaining quite a lot, but it doesn't really look that bad. Okay, I'll continue and remove the calendar and motion works. And now I can remove the automatic assembly. And letting the power down from the mainspring, which will allow me to safely remove the balance and the pallets. And now I can remove the train wheels and the mainspring barrel. Turning the movement over, I can remove the keyless works. Now I can remove the components from the automatic bridge. The barrel lid was slightly loose, which is not a good thing. Opening it fully, I can see that it's quite messy in there with the old grease. But that's it stripped down. I'll give all the parts a really good clean off camera. I have another video on the channel which shows this process in more detail, but in reality it's just 30 minutes of a basket spinning around in various cleaning and rinsing solutions. And now the parts are cleaned, I can start to assemble. and I'll start with winding the mainspring back into the barrel. And now I can assemble the train of wheels. Thank you. and with that done, I can secure the click spring and the ratchet wheel. Now I can install the keyless and MotionWorks components. I'll double check that the end stones are spotless and I can lubricate and refit those. I can now install the pallets. Now I can secure the balance assembly and oil its end stone. And as I suspected, it's running fairly well. It needed a little bit of tweaking, but altogether not bad for the age of this watch. Okay, now to rebuild the automatic works. and it can be secured to the movement. And now the calendar components can be fitted. So now with the movement assembled and running well, I can repair the dial. I'm using a cement, which should not cause any damage to the dial lacquer, and will secure the parts to the dial without really leaving a mess. Thank you. And with that done, I can now secure the dial and the hands to the movement. Okay, it's time to put all this together. And that's it. Looks a lot better now, and it's running well to boot. Let me know what you think in the comments below, and if you can, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.